Okay, so if you're having trouble matching each side up, try and work with points. So what I'm doing is, if I'm looking straight ahead at my mirror, this point here comes to just at the edge of my iris. So, and going long ways comes to about that level. So if we match up those two, should be about there. And then just continue on like that. Now the next bit depends on how you want to do it. If you just want to do it really simply, then you can just line that in black and you're pretty much good to go. If you want to make a little bit more depth, make a little bit more three-dimensional, the photo that I'm working off kind of has a third dimension to it. So I would go and make these a little bit wider, and then I'm going to draw a line down center there. And same at the top. I'm not bringing it all the way down. And then in each of these wee boxes, you're going to do a slightly different shade. So in one of them you'll have a solid black, and the other one you'll have varying degrees of grey. Okay, so I've fixed up anything I need to fix up. Now I'm taking a pencil with a really, really sharp nib, I don't think that's the right word. Anyway, and I'm just gonna line around the outside. I'm gonna do that with a sponge on my hand just so that I don't smudge anything else. Okay, so it's not perfect. I've blurred the lines a little bit in places, but you know, from a distance nobody's going to notice anyway, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. Now the last thing that I'm going to do to make it just look that little bit more three-dimensional is I'm going to take a brush, and I'm just going to use a tiny bit of this grey and a tiny, tiny hint of black. And I'm just gonna put that underneath to make it look like a shadow. And for this, I'd almost suggest using a really cheap eyeshadow. I'm using my Grimace palette, and it's really good. But the problem is that it's really good. And I have quite a lot of trouble blending away. I've got to work at it for ages. Sometimes just grab a Q-tip and just get into it that way. Okay, well, I've done my shading, and as I said, the palette that I'm using is really not the right product to use because it doesn't blend very well, and I've made a big hash of it, and now it's looking pretty mini. But anyway, you saw what it looked like before. It wasn't looking too bad. So I'm just going to finish off with the lips now. And in the photos, some of the photos she has black lips, some of the photos she has red lips, so I'm going to do red for now. But you can do whatever you want. And one last little trick that I have is that, well, all the photos that I looked at, she's a rather buxom lady. So if you are going to wear, whatever you're going to wear, if you've got bosom showing, I would try and accentuate it just a little bit by using a bronzer or a blush. Just in the valley. And maybe just take a little bit of highlight. And it's just going to make them look a little bit bigger.